Hello everyone, it is Toby here, back for another episode of Minecraft, the Lord of the Rings, and this episode we have got some things to do. I've still got a load of stuff in my inventory, and shall I tell you why that is? It's because last time I played this, I wasn't recording. Yes, that is right. I have been playing without you guys. Sorry about that. There is a reason for that, though. I will go into detail about that in just a second here. Let me just chuck away everything we have that don't entirely need at this point, but there we go. Yeah, if we go on the map, we have to go... Basically, this episode, we're doing the Essen Moors, Cold Fells, and Angmar, starting in the Cold Fells, travelling through to Essen Moor, round and up into Angmar. And you may be thinking, Toby, you are an absolute idiot. You will get absolutely slain and killed to death very quickly, because there is nothing good on the good side of elves, dwarves, men, that sort of thing. There is nothing good there, and if I was dying to just simple raids and stuff, I'm gonna have no chance. Well, that, my friends, is why I went into Linden over here. Really? Rain. I don't usually use cheats, but I'm gonna toggle down for the rain. That's the only cheat I'm gonna be using. It's just a lot easier, and I'm getting a little bit of knocking frame lag when the rain does come. But yeah, I went to Linden and I killed relatively a lot of my high elf companions, so I just got enough of Gundabad and Angmar that I don't get absolutely slain when I go back there. But if I look in this chest, I have some orc steel ingots, which I think we can craft some armor out of. So what do we have already? We have a Gundabad Uruk stuff. Okay, but do we have any Gundabad Orc stuff? I don't know, but we can now access this crafting table. Huh. Alright, what can this be used for? Uses. Block of Uruk steel. All of these, like, weapons and things. Oh, we can make... Angmar. Oh, it's for Angmar stuff. Oh, that makes sense. So we need an Angmar crafting bench. Or a Dol Guldur crafting bench. A Gundabad crafting bench. Oh, that's just to make some of this stuff. But, okay, basically we need to essentially get better crafting benches. How do we make this stuff? Doesn't seem to be a way. I mean, I can Google it, but we have a little bit of that just to craft into some more of that stuff. But we've lined the house in so much of this stuff. But as for now, we will be fast travelling over to Troll Shores, because that does seem to be the closest place to the Cold Fells up there. So let's fast travel to the Troll Shores, and basically I'm just going to run to the Cold Fells and get back with you when we're there. Okay guys, so I have just been exploring. I'm in Troll Shores at the moment, as you know. Tried to run north, and I went into this Rundahilman castle, which this one had some really good loot in it. I mean, I've been looting them as we go, but we got gold drill uses, block of gold drill, Morgul torch, fair enough. And we got some Angmar leggings, which are quite useful. Ooh, we'd need some more arrows, actually. And why'd I bring my leather hat? I mean, I guess I'm bringing my leather hat, but... Oh, they're slightly worse than my dwarven ones. So we'll just keep them there for an armor stand, but we will keep continuing on if I can get out of this place. Okay, so we are not far at all from the Cold Fells. We are just a couple hundred blocks away, and I thought I'd show you what we have from looting. We got a ton of stuff. So we got a Mordor axe, an Angmar axe, an orc bow, a Mordor war scythe, tons of ingots, two orc bombs, which sound quite fun, a ton of stuff. Let's reorganize our inventory a little bit. But yeah, we got a lot of stuff that will be quite useful. Let's actually use the Mordor axe as our axe, just so we have one of the axes from in the game, rather than just a boring old iron axe. And the Mordor axe seems like quite a cool axe. But I haven't been attacked, which is all, like, proper. We are best friends with all of these guys. Hello. Nagberg. I don't trust you, Maggot. Oh, well, okay, he doesn't trust me, but he's not attacking me. Well, that's all right. But, all right, how far are we? We're not far. We're literally just on the verge of the Cold Fells. Still, I'm also looking for one of these guys with a quest that's quite achievable. That looks like the Cold Fells because the grass color change. Up ahead, that's how I always determine the biomes, because they do that in real life, right? The grass changes color completely. We are here. Hello, Zagog. The Gundabagor. We are here. What achievement was that? The Wild North. So, we probably just want to have a bit of a run around. There's not much here. There is stuff here. But, yeah, there's a lot of the same stuff all over the place, if that makes sense. So, a lot of the stuff we're seeing here will be seen all around the place. And these are all Uruks now, so we are slightly more scared of them. There's a lot of Uruks. No, there aren't actually any roads up here either, so... Yeah, we got a load of space to do all of that sort of stuff. And we got this lovely Angmar brick as well. Yeah. What else is there really to say? Not much. I mean, there's a river cutting Coldfells and Ettenmoors in half. So, we're going to do a little exploration of the Coldfells. Just a little exploration. There's not too different... There's not too much different about the Coldfells and Ettenmoors. They're just two different places. Oh! You, sir, are killing me. Why? I don't know. Oh, for goodness sake. Why am I... Do I have to put up with this guy? Really? Alright. We need to run away. So trolls will still attack you, whilst orcs won't. I wasn't entirely expecting that. I thought they would be aligned with the general bad guys of the game. Alright, so we got him. You killed him. Alright, we got... Raw rabbit. Nice. Where am I being shot at? What? Oh no, my plans have completely failed. Okay, so the troll attacked us, and by killing the troll, we've gone down in alignment with the orcs, and all of my plans have gone to complete awfulness. Well, what we are going to have to do then is go to Linden, kill two or three elves, come back, and sort that out, basically. So... I'm going to do that, and I'm going to rejoin you guys in Ettenmoors, I'm going to rejoin you guys in the Ettenmoors, providing that when I come back here, I don't find anything in... Well, actually, no. Scrap that. I'm going to go straight to the Ettenmoors when I come back from Linden. Okay, so I join you in Ettenmoors. I've had a bit of a run around up here already. I went in here, I've been running towards Angmar, just to make this clip a bit of a... two-in-one situation where we jump into Angmar as well as the Ettenmoors, because the Ettenmoors, they're really not that different from the Lone Lands or Coldfells. They're just quite barren. There's a couple of structures here and there I've been looting, but nothing too significant that stands out to me. I mean, once we get into Angmar, maybe it'll be a bit different. But yeah, as I said, I sorted out the alignment, so I went and killed a couple of High Elves just to get my alignment back to where it should be, and for future reference, avoid trolls, because despite them not listening when you have positive alignment with Angmar people, and you go kill one thinking it won't affect it, yeah, it does affect it. The trolls will kill you, and then once you kill the troll trying to kill you, it changes the alignment for the orcs, and then they try kill you, and it's not a fun time. So don't get involved with any of that. That is some premium advice from me, but let's have a look in this chest. We got a ton of nice stuff. There we go. But I'm just sort of running around finding these random castles or stuff, but there's just the occasional pine tree, spruce tree with... Oh, no, we don't seem to have a troll horde down there. The occasional spruce tree, pine tree, whatever sort of tree. We've got boulders everywhere, uneven terrain, kind of a sort of nightmarish terrain to traverse anyway. Not as bad as a jungle, though. Oh, that frame rate wasn't nice, but we are encroaching upon Angmar. Oh, there, we got a house. We have a house. No, we are encroaching upon... Oh, that's a big drop. We are encroaching upon Angmar for the fourth time. I'm trying to spit that sentence out. So hopefully we'll be able to find an Angmar crafting table so we can craft up some orc... not just chest plates, orc armor and stuff like that. But hello, you're not going to try to kill me this time. We've got Angmar pickaxe, Angmar axe, nothing new there. Gosh, get better loot. I mean, I've looted literally all of your friends, but get better loot. But here we are, Angmar, just up here by the looks of things. What is this? Well, that generated weirdly. Just a sheer cliff. Well, it looks like we're going to have great fun trying to traverse Angmar. The ruin of Arnor. Angmar, we are here. And it's... Okay, you're not going to try kill me. Good. The sky's gone and mustied. Oh, a hill. You look much worse than before. You're going to try kill me, aren't you? Oh, by throwing rocks at me. Let's run away. We don't want anything to do with you. You look mean. Wow, Angmar is a scary place, and there are so many trolls everywhere that I'm just going to have to try and avoid, but... On a serious note, I am so glad we've got this alignment sorted. Whatever we do not want to kill a troll. Because then we will go under the alignment, and then we're in a bad situation if we're sat in Angmar without positive alignment. But here's a troll horde. We got some Mordor stuffs. Some more coins. Mordor chest plate, I already have one. Arnorian stuff, we've got a lot of that. Do I even need to bring coins anymore? I don't even know. Right, let's get out of here. There we go. And let's keep heading north towards the sort of Angmarian mountains so we can get a taste of those, because now we've unlocked Khandum. But that's a long way, so we may end up fast traveling to Khandum. But I do want a good run around of this area beforehand. But this place just doesn't look nice, does it? What is this? Waste block. Oh, I don't like these trolls that come out of absolute nowhere to just come and ruin my day. Why can't they just be friendly? I mean, the wargs are friendly and they're wilder than trolls. Ah, goodness. Oh, well, we got trolls to worry about, but that's it, honestly. I'm so glad we don't have to worry about these orcs or Rundahilmen, because look how many of them there are. Imagine how slaughtered I'd get if I had to deal with all of this stuff. I mean, luckily I had some good thinking about me where I was just having a random conversation. What is this? Oh, is this an Angmarian crafting bench? It is! Nice. It's weird stuff. But no, yeah, I was having a conversation with someone who watches these videos. And I was talking about how I may go to Angmar in the coming episodes. Collect 3 Angmar swords. No. But yeah, we were having a conversation about how I could possibly go to Angmar in the next episode. And they were just like, yeah, do it, but you will get absolutely slaughtered. And then I was just... generally talking about the logistics of trying to get into Angmar and having a good explore without dying. And then it suddenly crossed my mind that the alignment, the whole alignment system, would allow me to be able to come positive with orcs. And I then realized I had done so many quests for the... high elves that it would allow me to be... Alright, we need to... Let's get rid of this mutton. Not mutton, rabbit. But no, since I had done so many quests, it would allow me to be able to kill the... Oh, that was a troll that hit me on the butt. Anyway, yeah, that it allow me to kill enough orcs. Not orcs, enough... who are they? Linden elves, the high elves. That it would be able to get me to positive alignment with Gundabad and Angmar, but also keep me in positive alignment with high elves, which, I mean, that's just perfect. I'm positive alignment with a lot of people at the moment, which is great, because that's honestly also how I roll, kind of, in the real lives. So I try to be positively aligned, yes, I try to be friendly with everyone until I decide, okay, I want to be their enemies and kill them. And then I become like, no, it's not kill them, but I until I become their... Basically, yeah, I don't even know what I'm talking about, but that... These trolls are so big, these hill trolls, and they are too scary, and I don't like them, and I want to run away. There are so many just... Oh, no. Oh, there's a troll horde. with a mortal war scythe. Oh, dear. How did I get myself in this mess, then? Right, looks like we're gonna have to dig our way out of here, but... Yeah, we got a lot of exploration to do, but... This series is absolutely mad. I mean, I was... Who blew up what? Who was that? Come on, own up. No, this series, I mean... There's an orc in the tree. Right, now I'm getting distracted. Yeah, this series is absolutely madness. The last episode, considering the episode beforehand got 14 views, but the last episode where we went to find the trolls and troll shores and like the lone lands and the angle and all that area, that's currently sitting on my second monitor at the moment on 60 views. 60 is like unheard of for my channel. I mean, I've gained 17 subscribers since I started this series, like, this month, which, I mean, this is just incredible. So I can definitely tell that you guys are liking this series, so if you do want more, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe saying we want more. And also, tell me where you want to go next episode, because I'm tempted now that the Misty Mountains is our next area, except we could go to... Erijon, I don't know, or Dunland, or Anendwaith. There's a couple of areas down here we should probably explore, but yeah, we've done a lot. We've done all of this area here. This river's kind of bordering what we haven't done, which, I mean, that we've done quite a bit. That's a lot more than we did last series, to say the least, and last series only lasted 7 episodes, and we're on... this is the 9th episode, so yeah, we're getting there, we're doing quite well, and I'm hoping to actually make it to somewhere like Mordor this episode, yes, we're going to make it all the way to Mordor this episode, no, we are going to make it to Mordor this series, definitely, I'm going to make it past Mordor, go to Rûn and Harad, and all of those areas that I haven't been to before, which should be very entertaining, but I can't believe, for one, that we're still getting frame rate, but we also haven't found an Angmar tower yet. Because that would be very nice to find an Angmar tower. And we haven't found one, but no, this biome, honestly, I really like this biome, despite the angry trolls, but other than that, Angmar is now I think it's now my favourite biome to go to. It's just so... engrossing, like, not engrossing, is that the word? Immersive, that's probably a much better word to use than engrossing, but it's very immersive. The sky changes, the trees sort of crowd around you, there are orcs and trolls everywhere you turn. It's just what I imagine Angmar to kind of be like in The Lord of the Rings, and it's a crazy, crazy place, the Fallen Kingdom of the North. It's just ridiculous, and I absolutely love it, and there are trolls everywhere. I thought I'd run into like a couple trolls, but no, we're getting like spawns of 2 trolls that I have to ignore, and there's a quest which I'm not going to do because of the trolls. Oh lord. trolls are not fun. Right, so I'm going to keep going. If I do find anything else of interest except more orcs in trees, I will catch you back. Other than that, I will catch you back when we reach the Angmar Mountains and see what sort of sights they have to behold, because I can imagine it's going to be quite impressive. We are atop a humongous Angmar tower, towering over everything, as you could probably expect, but this is where we get our Angmarian banner. Where's it gone? I don't want it to fall off the edge, please. Alright, we got one. Banner of Angmar. That would be a lovely addition to our collection. But no, these towers are mad. They don't seem to have any loot in them, which is unfortunate. But we do have a lovely, lovely structure to look at anyway. It's all ruined and everything, as most of the structures are, but look at that. It's huge. There's banners everywhere. But we got one of the banners. We got a banner of Angmar. That's all we need for our decoration. But yeah, we can just keep... We'll just keep running north up all the way to Khandum. Actually, I am being stupid. Absolutely stupid. Oh, that's a big troll. It's two big trolls. Let's run away. Let's find sort of a safe area to stand behind this tree and simply click the F button. Why did I not do that before, you ask? Well, I was trying to find an Angmar tower, is obviously my excuse. I wasn't just being stupid and didn't realize I should have done that. But we are going there now, so we should be able to find and look at some amazing mountains. I mean, they're probably not going to be on par with the Blue Mountains. Or will they be? Ooh, they look very nice. Wow, they are tall. I mean, they back onto Frodwraith, so of course they're going to be huge and cold. And there don't seem to be any... Oh, there's a troll. I was about to say there don't seem to be any trolls up here, but of course they do. They're mountain trolls. Of course there'll be trolls. But no, these mountains are crazy. Absolutely crazy. Wow. Okay, well, yeah, these are breathtaking mountains. And it's snowing, so I'm glad I'm in the mountains, because otherwise it doesn't make a noise, but... The frame rate, I mean. Jeez. Okay, we've got... Have we? We haven't explored tundra before, have we? Should we pop our heads into tundra? Just pop down to have a look what tundra's all about. And then we'll come back, but... Like, it's just another biome to explore crossed off the list, I guess. Okay, this is rain. We're not technically in tundra yet, but a big troll man. Two more big trolls. Don't want anything to do with them, just a random snow block. Well, it looks like we will be going to tundra quite soon. Or are we in tundra right? No, we're not in tundra. Tundra. Looks like tundra maybe up here somewhere. Or is that just a room? Frozen lake. Wow. Oh, that was you. Right, stop. I swear, trolls are... just annoying creatures. Oh, there seems to be tundra here. Yeah, that makes sense. It's just kind of plain, isn't it? What is that? I just see a deer in the mist. Just an elk. It's also a big hole. I want to explore the hole. No, we are more than definitely in tundra right now. We don't want to go up into Frodwraith. That wouldn't be ideal. We won't, because we probably die, and I want to save that for another episode. But yeah, that vision of the mountains out of that's gonna be a thumbnail. Right, well, that seems to be a lot of what there is for Angmar and such. I mean, I'll explore more of the Angmar Mountains just to get a better feel of it, but yeah, I am very happy with that biome. That is a nice biome, Angmar. The big trolls, just everything. Just all I can say is just wow. We've got so much loot today as well. A lot of loot, which is incredible. And yeah, we got a whole new biome checked off the list. A big one as well. Angmar, one of the basically the Witch King of Angmar probably lives in there somewhere. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm really tired, alright? Story time. This is actually being recorded rather late at night, and I have been doing revision for my exams that I have, GCSE exams. And yes, they're not until a while, but I've started revision now, and I spent a good few hours doing that, so I thought I'd hop on and do a video, so my voice probably seems croaky, I probably seem out of it, very tired, easily distracted. So I do apologize about that, but if you have made it this far, thank you, and I hope you do continue to watch and yeah, see what else we find in the rest of the episode. Are you guys ready for the most ridiculous sight to end our trek in Angmar? He's just around here. What are you doing up there, my friend? More importantly, how do... Oh god, look, these are the normal trolls. I thought they were big. But no, the mountain trolls, the hill trolls are huge. And there's one of them stood on a dead tree. Just a one block thin spruce pillar. And why am I running into the big trolls? Oh dear, no, that was a bad idea. But there's one of them just up there. There's two-headed as well. Just chilling up on his post. That's brilliant. I'm going to take a screenshot of that. Oh, and he's got a rock. Let's get an underground. What is this? Oh, probably an ore I've already got. No, we're going to hide out underground. L it up. And go home, because that is all that we've got time for to do in Angmar. It's getting extremely late, so I need to sleep, and I want to get this episode out to you guys. But this episode has been crazy. I've enjoyed it. Those big hill trolls, they are brutes compared to the normal little trolls. Like, they really put it into perspective of how big some of these things are. I mean, just the fact that, wow. Wait, can you turn them into stone? Like, can you have a giant stone troll? Ooh, I'll have to look that up. But anyway, we are home. Hey, hobbits, we are home. Let's put our Angmar crafting table in the collection, of course. Let's remove this one. There we go. That looks cool. Let's put all the stuff away that we do not need. Let's put... No, we'll keep them here. Put them in here. Oh, we've got a lot of stuff. Okay, we've actually ended up moving on to the next chest here. But first off, let's put all of the stackables in here. There we go. And then let's move down here where we can put troll... Wait, do we have troll bones in there? No, we'll put troll bones down below with this. That can go on a armor stand. That can go down there. This stuff here as well. This can go here. These I keep on me. These can go on armor stands. This can go in here. Ooh. We've actually run out of space for the next banner. Well, there we go. Just make some renovations. Simple as that. We'll just take away this lovely spruce trim that's been implemented in the house. There we go. The Angmar banner looks awesome. Right, that looks awesome. We're getting more and more banners every day, which is great. But no, now we need to make some of those weapon racks. And if I remember correctly, do we have any sticks? We have a couple. They are just crafted like this. Yeah, I did remember correctly. How many do we need? One, two. So we need one, two, three, four, five. Okay, so we need five. So we've got one, two. All right, we need some more wood, but So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect amount of stuff. There we go. Okay, let's stick sticks back. Sticks back. Yep, I know. And let's put these up somewhere. Where can we put them? No, this is our armor room. We can't put them in here. We could put them in our bedroom. Well, actually, let's remove that. Put that back. There we go. So, what do we want to put where? We'll put an Angmar axe on the end. That's my... Yeah, that's an Angmar axe. Put next to it a Mordor scythe thingy to do. A... One of them. But that can probably end up going there because it's huge. Wait, we don't even want to put that there. Let's put that above the door because that's massive. Let's put that in the middle of there. And that on there. And we got some nice stuff. Great. Anything else? We need to make some more armor stands, of course. Actually, let's use this one because I'm not going to have a hat stand anymore. Let's put this one in here. So, what do we have here to add? We got Angmar stuff. We need to make some more Gundabad Urk items, which we have enough of. So we need chest plate and boots for that. So let's take this stuff. Ooh, we're running short on the Gundabad stuff. Let's make a chest plate for now on the Uruk stuff. So we got a crude worker. And for the Angmar stuff, we need a helmet and boots. We got more than enough for that. Wrong place. Angmar chest crafting. What was it? Helmet and boots. Helmet and boots. Great. Great stuff, great stuff. We can put them on there. Armor stand, we got another completed armor set there. That looks great. We need some boots for this guy. And we got our first piece of Mordor armor, which I'll make an armor stand for. Let me quickly just research how to make... I could do that on my phone, actually. How to make Uruk steel. Make Gundabad... Wait, what's it called? Uruk steel. Uruk steel Lotra mod. There we go. Uruk steel ink. How is that made? There we go. Alloy producing the Orc Forge. How do you make it in the Orc Forge? But it's great to tell me that it's an alloy produced in the Orc Forge, but to tell me that it what it needs to be. Uruk steel by alloying iron ingots and coal. Okay, so that's pretty simple. Iron ingots and coal. I can do that. How much do we need? We need two. Okay, we can put this stuff back in here. There we go. That'll make us two of that. And in the meantime, we better create some armor stands. Is it what I think it is? It must be, I think. There we go, we got plenty of those. We can place them all down in here for future armors. Perfect. Right, well, we could put this Mordor chest plate, which you obviously probably make. The Orc still in a Morgul crafting bench, which we need to get probably in a future episode. But there we go, that can go there. And we have plenty of space to put more armors up on the armor stands. We got this stuff back. Uruk steel ingots. Where is my Gundabad crafting bench? There we go. And boom, we've got... Ooh, we need to get the achievements for wearing all the armor. I forgot about that. Okay, well, let's start with this one. The Uruk stuff. So let's take our armor off, put this stuff on. Scourge of the Mountain. I look mean in that, mate. That's crazy. Right. Do we get the same armor if we put that on as opposed to that? We do. No, I prefer the Blue Dwarven. It's more solid. And as for this Angmar stuff, let's put this on. There we go. Fourth to Ruin. Let's put our stuff back on. Oh, I've left that helmet. Oh, what helmet do I think looks better? Nah, this one. Well, actually, we've got to keep them on the armor stands. There we go. We got some more achievements. That is all I have got time for this episode as well. So, we have got a lot of cool... There's one thing we need to do. Where is my plant pot stuff? Where are my flowers? Do we have flowers, everyone? Doesn't look like it. Right, let's get flowers from outside real quick. I got a comment on my earlier episode by... I don't remember what the guy's name was. Someone left a comment anyway, and he said we could dye our hat. So if we get pink, I want a pink hat, maybe. We can get a pink hat. Oh my goodness. I look so great. That is brilliant. I look fabulous. Thank you to whoever left that comment. What is that? Oh, I feel so bad now. Well, I'm going to find out what his name was. How do I do that? Comments. Okay, what was your name, person? Noah Plays. Noah Plays. Thank you for commenting that down below and giving me the swankiest of leather hats. I'm actually going to leave that on every episode now. Because that looks fabulous. We'll stick this guy in here and I'll die in this chest probably. And there we go. That is everything needing to be done this episode. Angmar, what a crazy place to explore. That's amazing. Never went there before. That place is now my new favorite biome, I'm pretty sure. But as for next episode, we will most likely go to the either the Misty Mountains. Actually, no, we're gonna go to Eregion, I'm gonna say, and an Edwaith as well. And explore, and probably Dunland, and this sort of area here. And then do the Misty Mountains next, after that. But, yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. I'm sorry this episode took slightly longer to come out than the previous ones, and that is only because I had to do all of this grinding for the alignment with the orcs, so I don't get killed wherever I go. But... yeah, that's just something I had to do. So thank you so much for watching. If you do remember, if you want to speak to me as my personal self, I do have a Discord you can join in the description below. So you can just come chat with me. Just tell me you're there. And if I am free to talk, I will get in a voice chat and talk to you about stuffs. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. I've been Toby, and that is the end of the episode. Goodbye.